I thought that it'd be appropriate to start my video when Malia arrived at Carbonation during her love bombing stage, so you guys could see the extreme contrast. And maybe, you know, how somebody, maybe even you, could fall into something like this. I'm certainly not judging. I have compiled about a dozen devastating videos of Malia being attacked or somebody describing an assault that she sustained in Carbonation. And although the cult currently appears peaceful now that Poppy is in protective custody, if he beats this charge, Malia's back to getting beaten on a regular basis. And I think that this footage also sets the scene of the intimidating environment that Natiri claims to have been assaulted in. And I wanted to dispel this false narrative of a utopian, self-sustaining, harmonious village that Malia and the other members are describing, because it's bullshit. And Eligio is actually telling these young women, half his age, that if they loved him, they would attack any female that disrespected him immediately. And Malia, arguably Natureboy's, you know, number one wife currently, has a bullseye on her back because of the constant competition that Eligio creates around being queen. A title that Malia just recently got by default. Nobody's ever good enough. He hangs it over their head, you know, dangles it. And last but not least, I want to address Eligio's enforcers, Zoka and Eferu. It's not that I don't like you, but you guys, y'all attack Malia more for Eligio's approval than anything else. And I have a hard time understanding that, because you guys saw Malia damn near die of an untreated STD or a traumatic injury, both. It's a multitude of things. And I don't get why these bitches are beating her, better yet, jumping her. And then Natureboy wants to say that Velvet caused Malia's illness by fighting her and biting her on the beach, which arguably is Malia's only violent incident that I know of. But I've only been watching 2-3 years, and there's hours and hours and on the end of a video, and that's why I'm trying to get the highlights for you. Bottom line, Eligio is to blame for Malia's illness one way or another. He's responsible for the chaos, cruelty, the constant competition to be queen when the position's an illusion. Like the self-sustaining village that he said he built 6 years ago. You'll know a tree by the fruit that it bears. And Natureboy is rotten to the core. And anything he touches rots along with him.
Very loving being. He's very caring. He's very holy.
Malia ain't no bully over there. Malia
She ain't no bully. She do look like she can pop off. Cause you see, she beat Velvet.
Let me tell you what he did.
He made her fight Velvet. No, she didn't want to fight.
He did.
He did. What he did to her?
She whooped that ass. I was fucked over there. Malia had got her ass whooped by all of them at some point.
That's why she got broken ribs.
But they be jumping her though. That'd be the fucked up part. He be having her.
I knew it.
She don't never get a one-on-one. You have to understand that. That day, remember, he had everybody put the windows, put the beds and shit up against the windows. This is in California. Against the windows, the bed frames was in the closets, and he had all the men circle around the bed frames and the wall. And then he had Malia coming. He had Star. He had what's the other bitch named Civil? He had
Velvet
and Zoka. They were standing, and they all was like, "Bitch, if you touch her, we gonna beat your ass. You just gotta take it." And she had to take her ass, ran and crawled under my. This is because she was checking my chart one day, and we was having a real nigga moment, and he kept asking her why she was checking my chart, and she was like, "I don't like Shaka." And then she was like, "Fuck it." She stormed out and left. So when she came back, he was like, "Oh, bitch, you took my phone. You about to get this ass." He made it seem like it was about the phone, but it was really about he was trying to make Nana feel good about her position and herself in the camp, and that he was trying to show her that, "Oh, bitch, I support you as the queen." You know what I'm saying? So this bitch disrespected me. She disrespected you. So you need to handle this queen.
Every time basically, that happened, did he do like that?
Yeah. To Malia? Yeah.
But he wouldn't let Malia hit back.
Well, it didn't turn out successful because
you always talked about how good her pussy was.
Well, when they was fighting on that beach, Malia handed Velvet her ass.
Okay, Velvet
need one of those. He need to let Zoka get one with her in too, because I need to see that. Zoka got all that Aries mouth. I need to see that ass whooping. Malia gonna whip her ass too.
Oh, if you know the people that be talking too much, don't be really about it. The ones who be being quiet and humble be the ones that be
running. Exactly.
Malia was quiet when I was there.
When pushed to the limit.
Because that's how I am.
She was very humble when I was there, but again, they was fucking that girl.
But you gotta understand all
that.
You got
how
the most
trauma
when I was
you
there.
Gotta, approach me like a man, nigga. Shoot it to your savage. What's up? Go ahead, boy. You know what I'm saying, boy. And savage, like, you ain't ready for that, boy. Fuck that nigga. Keep mugging that nigga. He acting bad like Michael Jackson. Go ahead, man. What's up? 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 Got a problem, nigga, problem. What's that, I'm wrong? We can do this shit right now. You know how I get down. I ain't suck my dick, cause I fuck brains. Fight!
Are you done? No. Hold on. Hold on, mother. Come here, Nana. Come here, Nana. Stop right there.
We got all energy
and
out.
She bit your titty and everything, baby. Hey, look. Come here.
Right.
Come here. Stand right here.
I love my child.
Stand right here. I said stand right here. What I say? Stand right there. Fuck. I said stand right there.
I didn't know you meant to go.
I said stand right there. Fuck is you talking about? Stand right here. Fake shit online, nigga. It's real life, nigga. This real life, nigga. Y'all want that fake shit. This real. Fuck out of here, nigga. Hey, turn around. Turn around. Turn around. Stop. Look at the camera. Look at the camera. Look at the camera.
That shit fucked up. That's good.
What's up? What's that? Everything straight?
Everything good.
Nah, put your hand down. You straight?
I'm straight.
You sure?
I love myself. Look at that busted lip. Look at that titty. It's all right. Let these motherfucking demons out. What y'all doing?
That's what y'all doing. They watching. They ain't doing nothing but watching. Spectating. Nah, you straight?
I feel good.
You good?
Yeah.
All right. Y'all got it out? We got an understanding, though.
We got an understanding.
I'm pretty sure we do. We going to process that. Let's process that for a minute. You heard? You feel me? Let's process that for a minute, you heard?
It's a fact.
Y'all go do y'all thing and clean up. We got an understanding, though? Because I tried talking with y'all. The whole world see me trying to talk with y'all. But that shit ain't want to happen. Y'all been wanting to fight for the longest. Haven't y'all? Haven't y'all? Haven't you?
That's a fact.
God damn, that's a big ass stretch. Woo! Alright.
It's good. It's good.
What is that?
What's that?
Who hair is that?
Hey, look. Hey, yo. Hug back. Hug back. Let's go. Nana still want to fight. God damn, bitch.
Nana,
you want, how many more rounds you want to go?
I'm good.
How
many more rounds can you go?
You know what? We got that Mars and 12 house. We got a lot of angles. It's good, though. It's good.
Mars and 12 house. But we got to understand it right now. So we good?
So therefore, I disrespected myself with my actions I decided to take. And with knowing what I did, I feel very crazy for even thinking that was okay to do. So from this apology letter forward, I will be taking the necessary steps to get back in good graces with my king and empress, understanding my role and rank in carbonation. I bow down respectfully to myself.
Go ahead and bow down. Period.
Tell these people what you want to do. You need some dick, don't you? Tell them why you acting up. Tell them why you acting up. Because I'll play you in front of these motherfucking people. I don't give a fuck about these people. I'm a real man. They want me behind bars. Real niggas like me behind bars. Yeah. Yeah. You want real? This is real, nigga. This real, nigga. Yeah, her book was right. Fuck that whore. Fuck that bitch and fuck you. Blink twice for a nigga if you need to get saved. Blink twice. You don't want it. Don't save her. She don't want to be saved, nigga. Nigga. Fuck out here, nigga. I'm a real nigga. I'm a good. I'm gonna put you to sleep. That make me feel like a man when I you like that. That make me feel good. Cause outside of that, you gonna run your fucking mouth. Let me punch you in your shit. I'm an abusive man. That's what I am. That's what I am. I need a woman that like to be abused. What the nigga say? Hold up. Yo, Ma, give me your phone. I need a like Tina. I need a the ass like Trina. That like to get beat like Tina. You feel me? I need a real.
Everything from shoes to coat hangers, once putting a burning cigarette to her lips.
Okay, I can stop you. I know where you're going. Okay, with all of this, if you look at Tina, you see any of those scars? She said, I broke her jawbone. If you ask the doctor, a doctor can tell you, if I broke her jaw, no way is she going on stage.
You admit that you have slapped Tina before, but why, Ike?
She would be walking around looking sad. Looking sad with a lip drop, and I keep asking her, and what is the matter with you? What's wrong? And as always,
nothing.
And it would go on for a day or two till finally, why the f*** don't you? And then this is where I would slap her or something. Then she would change her mood or her attitude or something. You're just a fool. You know. Let me tell you, I would say this. I would do no more to Tina, and I did no more to Tina than I would want somebody to do to my mother.
That's it. That's it. Y'all heard it, right? That's it. Right there. She said it. She got a choice. That's her choice. She said she wanna go. And that's it. Now, how many times, because we went viral, right? She gets to the airport, she say, I don't wanna leave. I don't wanna get off the airport. Bye. Get the fuck off the camera. Go pack your shit.
People can see that. This don't make
me
look
bad. This don't. Hey, y'all get ready. We about to go out. Okay. She can sit outside till we get back. I don't give a fuck what she want to do. She can walk the fuck off one time.
automatically. Give a fuck. Cause she ain't here. It ain't. She a grown woman. She walked the fuck off. She walked the fuck off. That's all. You know what I'm saying? Like, and don't pee on my porch either.
Yeah, no, I see my good. You see me, I'm good. Just send love. Just send love. Just doing a little breathing work, deep breathing. It's really good for you. I love you. I love myself.
I'm gonna tell my story. I'm not gonna let nobody else tell my story when I got my own media. I got my own media. Niggas is telling you stuff about me. No, I'm gonna tell my story. You wanna know about me? I expose myself. But you're here. You're here. And if anything happens, you here, you know it's gonna come back on me. You looking like that? You think you look good? You think you're at a healthy state? Do you think you're healthy? Why aren't you healthy?
Because of my mind and the way it works. The way that my negative thoughts work. Every time a thought come in, I think about it over.
Why are you talking like that? This is fucked up. I'm letting you go. I'm letting you go. I'm letting you go. Now, why are you talking like that, yo? You talking like, you know what I'm saying? Like niggas got like a fucking panel right there making you read off a prompt. Like, this is crazy. It's fucked up. It's fucked up. I got my decision. I'm flying you out to wherever you need to be, B. This shit ain't right, bro. It's fucked up. You know, use that shit against me, man. Gonna try to make it seem like, you know what I'm saying? Gonna make it seem like I'm gonna fucking over here make her do something. This shit is fucked up. I'm not letting this happen, dog. You don't give a fuck about me, my nigga. You don't give a fuck about me, my nigga. I gotta try. Oh,
$5,000 for the result. $5,000 for the result, y'all. I'm gonna flip this motherfucker with it.
And it grew to the point where my heart pumps very too fast, and there's a lot of pain there.
I feel you there.
It's a lot of pain in your heart.
Yeah, it's a lot of pain in that area, because my heart it's trying to pump past the fluids, but the fluids is in the way. So it's pumping too fast. It's pumping.
I thought they drained the fluid though, Malia.
They did, but I could still feel it. They give me medicine for it, but I still feel it. It's still there, and I try to manage it, but you can still feel it.
You know? So you have to breathe and stuff.
Yeah, I have to watch my
breathing. You're so sensitive.
But she stayed too long. They kept giving us stuff. When it was time for her to go, like she usually comes back, she couldn't do it because she felt bad because they had done so much for her. So at the end of the day, that's what they do. So I told Malia, stop receiving gifts from them and stop communicating with them and give them a note and tell them that you're going back to carbonation and you don't want to stay with them. Mm-hmm. You didn't want to accept their gifts, because if you accept their gift, they're going to make you feel bad for doing what you want to do with your life.
Right.
Period.
Right.
Hold on real quick. Let me mute you, because I'm trying to say something. So what you got to understand is the tactics of the devil. Now, they was giving Malia stuff, and she was sitting in the hospital, she getting her health better and everything, and hooked up to her IV, and she getting her little health better and everything, and they steady giving her gifts. And I said, yo, Malia, be careful, because they're going to make you feel bad if you want to come back. As soon as Malia says she want to come back here and get back on her spiritual path, they're not going to let you do that. And the more you accept from them, they're gonna, more bad you're going to feel by leaving. So stop accepting stuff from them so that you won't feel bad for making your own decision.
The liver procedure had to happen. That's why her kidneys are not functioning properly. She has tubes coming out of her back to drain mm-hmm. her organs because they're mm-hmm. not functioning properly. So mm-hmm. how is she okay? Like, how is she doing a... How is she even thinking and you know, going seem like she's fine? She's not fine. She really isn't. And, you know, that's the problem. Like, we just want to make sure she's good. We're not trying to hold her hostage down here. We get that she's an adult, but the fact is that she's not even in a position to go anywhere. Mm. So for her to restrict us from coming to the hospital to see about her, you know, that's our concern. That's why we're speaking, because now we're in a position where we cannot even know she's good, and we don't even know what's going to happen from this point because she doesn't want us up there.
Take responsibility for the things that you do. Stick up for yourself. Stick up for the things that you've done in your past, so you can live up to it. So you become a righteous being. So you can become godlike and godly and do the right thing. You should not point the finger at anyone or judge another person, because the same message that you judge that person, you're judging yourself. So look at self. Take responsibility for the things that you do. I'm in a predicament that I'm in because of the mindset and me not taking responsibility for me and me not keeping a healthy perspective. You must learn to look at your situation and own up to your situation. Look at self. Self-reflect. Get into your natal chart and
get on your knees right fucking now. Like, flat on your face, right? And she gets on her knees and literally puts her head on the ground. Let me make sure this is not about to die. This is important. All right, okay. Which she thought that she was following the right orders, like, you know, put my head on the ground. He said, no, put your head flat on the fucking ground, right? She put her whole body flat on the ground, right? What he did after that, he kicked her in the stomach. I mean, kicked her in the stomach, like, while she was on the ground like that. He said, this is what you get. Look at you. You hit yourself. Now, tell me, I'm there because he's my, I've gave my energy to him in that moment. And he's my teacher. And that's my role model, father figure. I'm just sitting there like, it's okay. She's a woman, she's acting up right now, and her man is disciplining her. But that's fucking wrong.
Yeah, Malia, nice and quiet now. She know, oh, you don't wanna fight Fufu. You don't wanna fight Fufu. You will fight IMU, but you don't wanna fight Fufu. You see that?
quiet, right?
Yeah, you fix. I'm small. Effing beat the fuck out of me. Yeah, just like all right, you well, say, big
niggas. I'll beat the fuck out you too. I'll beat the fuck out you too.
Big niggas will beat the fuck out you and you're gonna be out.
Ain't no, and let me say something. Let me say a big nigga can never beat the fuck out of me because I'ma kill that nigga. I'ma rip his motherfucking throat out, nigga.
I could. I did it in jail. I let a nigga bitch me in jail. You know why? Because I'm a smart nigga. And I know how. I know how. If I'm in a situation and I'm getting pumped and I can't win in that situation, I'm not stupid enough. I submit. If a nigga come up on me and I know I can't beat him, yo, bro, what can I do for you, bro? What's good? I know how to become whatever I need to become. Nigga, one thing about me, is I'm going to tell you like this, nigga. Straight up, nigga. I'm a survivor, bitch. I turn into whatever I need to turn into. I turn into a fucking roach to survive, nigga. I'm God. That's why when they talking about the gay shit I did in videos, I don't give a fuck, nigga. I did whatever I needed to get what I needed to get. And I'm willing to do anything I need to do.
Peace. No. You ain't never heard me say a big nigga fuck me up. I'm gonna tell you something. A big nigga might beat me, but he gonna have to kill me, nigga. Fuck is wrong with you? I'm fighting, nigga. Fuck wrong with you, nigga? I'm fighting, nigga. I'm fighting to the bloody end, nigga. You got me bent, but you ain't never heard me say that. But you ain't got my spirit. We ready? Come. Yeah. What's going on? What's up? Effu ready, nigga. You fucked her birthday up. What's up?
I'm trying to see.
What's up?
I'm not fighting anybody.
Stop acting bougie, motherfucker.
I'd rather get beat up than fight. That's not who I am. I'm a very loving person.
Then why you keep acting like you got a fucking attitude?
Because when I'm in my demons, I get up being prideful and thinking I have it all like that. But that's not who I am. It's a face that shows. That's Aries. But Pisces is very sensitive. It makes me very soft. That's not who I am. Like, they are always there for me.
They ready to handle business. They was with you. They was your sister, nigga. They were trying to stick up for you every day.
Yeah, and I feel that. But I feel like at the same time, I feel like they were against me.
Call the cops, nigga. Stop calling the cops and let us handle shit ourselves. That's what's wrong with y'all bitches.
I just want to apologize.
They say you fought Velvet. Why you don't fight Efru?
Because we're not... Me and Velvet was there. We're not there. Like, I don't feel like we
So why
have
you
that.
Keep acting like that?
Why you keep disrespecting Baba G?
Why you keep disrespecting me? Why you keep being ungrateful?
It's because you trigger me. You
I don't give a fuck. Why you keep fucking being ungrateful?
You need to look at yourself. Baba G not your enemy. Because when you treat him like one, this was going to happen.
That's a fact.
Go inside, yo. Go inside, bro. She don't want to fight, yo. Y'all go get dressed for the night. We going to see the fluorescent light tonight. It's your birthday, baby. We going to turn up. Hey. Tap in. Hey. Tap in, huh? Tap in. Let go. We going out tonight. Hey, yo. Baby. Hey. Yeah. Stop that bullshit, nigga. We going out tonight. Go get dressed, nigga. The way you punish Malia is just separate her ass from everybody. Give her, like, go put her in jail. That's why jail was invented, to give a nigga a break. But jail shouldn't be like that. Jail need to be a place where a nigga can sit down and be in isolation. But doesn't mean you have to be treated like that. I feel like the prison system is very, a very good system. It's just how we rehabilitating niggas. Because you making niggas worse putting them in there. If you had programs set up in there that's teaching them the, you know, law, education, allowing them to get educated, you know what I'm saying? They done took goddamn libraries out the fucking prison. You educate a nigga, he gonna get smarter, you know what I'm saying? But you make him dumber, he always gonna be a slave to stupidity. And so these prison systems ain't really, you know what I'm saying? But then again, I'm gonna tell you why. Cause a nigga be deserving that shit. You know what souls that be in prison? Mm. Ain't nobody falsely in prison. Prison is for motherfucking karma. Mm-hmm. So a bitch would be in there for something they didn't do. For karma, they paying off from something shit they did. Ain't no mistakes, bitch. You right where you supposed to be.
Yeah, that's real.
You better believe it. And the universe is calculating everything you do. You never get away with it. You'll get locked up for some shit you didn't do just because you getting paid back from the universe for some shit you did that you thought nobody seen, bitch. Mm. You gonna get your return. You gonna get your karma, bitch. See, like, you don't get away with nothing, man. You gotta be honest and be straight up with shit. Yeah.
The truth, what's up?
You know what I'm saying? It's not for profit in the big eye, because God is the universe is God, nigga. Mm-hmm. And human beings, what human beings is doing, God is doing. Mm-hmm. Who put my silk cloth upstairs, yo?
Who put Chief's silk cloth upstairs?
Chief 3.
Excuse myself.
Chief 3.
Who put Chief 3?
I think it was Chief 3. No, we already grabbed it. Okay, right here. I put it in the trash. Sorry.
Malia, you got an attitude?
No. What?
I feel like every time we get on the camera, that's when we start pointing out Malia's negative stuff. When we are not on camera, Malia be doing amazing. When Malia be on camera, that's when Malia's negative stuff start coming out. Start talking about.
Why is that, Malia?
I don't know, because the people online, that's all they see, so that's what they gonna.
No, I'm not talking about the people online. I'm talking about your mood, your attitude.
Yeah, I feel like I have a move, because I feel like...
I don't feel like you should go with us today. I don't feel like I'm feeling your vibe. Yeah, go ahead. Go to your room.
Because I literally was fine to...
No, you wasn't fine. And you haven't even apologized for what you did earlier.
I did apologize, and we didn't move.
You didn't apologize, and you're not apologetic in this moment. You don't feel like you sorry. A bitch can say I'm sorry out of her mouth and not be apologetic. It's about being apologetic to the universe. You getting away with too much, man. You getting away with too fucking much, Malia. You're spoiled. You need to take your ass to the room, take a time out. Bitch, I ain't about to vibe with nobody in my front seat that ain't got no positivity. Come on, you come in. Look.
And that's what I feel. I do feel like you've been saying...
Well, you manifesting that. That's what you manifested. Look, you just manifested it. That wasn't true, but you just did. Give me the phones.
You do care.
You ain't got to care. Run out the door and run down the block then.
You've been saying,
hey, well, first of all, calm the fuck down. That, shut the fuck up.
Why am I here?
Shut up.
If y'all don't like me.
Shut up. Hey,
what? If hold I don't it. Want to be here.
Come on, Malia, why are you doing this?
Let her take it there. Let her take it there.
That's
no,
too far.
All right, come on.
No. All right.
Okay, we're leaving. Leave.
She gonna get us in trouble, bro.
Man, somebody hit my ass. Yo, fuck up. No, stop that. That's crazy, bro. Go ahead. Do y'all thing. Do y'all thing, man.
What is it called? A hide and seek? We're playing hide and seek, Captain. Yeah. We are just gonna show you every time they call the cops. What's going on, Malia? You still got a problem? You wanna go out there with the officer? Huh? I can't hear you.
You are my black man.
What you mean?
He's connected to a system that's about to fall.
But you said he not your black man. I never said him. I said the white man.
I don't. That's not my jurisdiction. My jurisdiction is right here.
You sound like you scared. Mm-hmm. The police is right there. If you want to go out the door, you can go, Malia.
The police is right. No, go. No, take your bags. Go get your shit. And the police is right there. You can go, Malia.
I don't want to go with them.
You want to stay here?
Yes.
That's a nice ass shirt. Who bought you that shirt?
It's actually a dress.
Okay, so, but
it's from the flea market.
You I ain't asked you where it was from. I said, who bought you that?
You bought it free.
Who bought all your clothes?
You did that.
I bought all your clothes, right? Outstanding.
Outstanding.
Who feeds you?
You do three.
I feed you, don't I? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Who's your commander in chief?
You are my chief.
Who do you answer to?
You do my chief.
You answer to the authority or my authority?
Your authority.
Outstanding.
I'll stand out.
She said, let's see the dress. They want to see the dress.
Oh,
this is what I picked that out. I told her to get that. turned around. That's nice. See, you should have wore that. That'd have been harder than shit. Maybe you would never been in trouble. You should have worn it like that. I told you to get the shit. Don't tuck it in.
That's what the issue was. The abdomen too tight. That's what it was. They had to pull the dress
out. Who told you to get that shirt?
You
ain't want to get it. I said get it. Didn't I tell her get it?
Towards Ryan and be like, think about
it. Bitch, you're not getting a lot of my energy. Slap her. What the fuck is wrong with you, bitch? Keep playing with God. Come on, ho. Get out of my limelight, ho. Bitch trying to be in my limelight. Fuck wrong with
them. Hey, can we get a coaster
over here? Of course I love her. That's why I put her under so much pressure. Because I want to see if she'll, just like God do you. God will tempt you. I'm the devil and I'm God. I'm always going to put you through tests and see if what you're going to do. And see if you're loyal. If you deserve what I'm going to give you. If you deserve what I'm going to give you. Because I got blessings for you, but you got to be loyal to me. Sit your ass down. Why don't you ever stand over me? Matter of fact, get on your face. Oh, look at her. Somebody feel sorry for her. Fuck out of here, bitch. I don't feel sorry for you. Because don't nobody feel sorry for me. Ain't nobody ever felt sorry for me. That's what made me God. I'm self-proclaimed, bitch. I don't need your approval. Oh, my servant? You talking about Malia? Yeah, Malia, she... Even if you go to a sorority or fraternity, you have to go through some kind of hazing or something. You know what I'm saying? Like, y'all think this shit ain't normal? This shit is very normal. We could be a sorority house. Come save her. Look at her. She want to be saved, y'all. Come save her. She's sending y'all all the signals. She don't want to do this no more. She can't do it. Please come save her.
Bring up the remote to the back room. Bring up the remote to the back room.
Oh, it's over there.
Push it direct.
She get treated the best, don't she? Malia get all the dick, don't she?
Yes.
Don't you, Malia? You get treated the best. You get most attention out of all the girls, don't you? Why you give me most of the problems? Look at this. Look at this. Look at the scenario, y'all. Who get the most attention out of the group? Press 3 if you see Malia get all the fucking attention out of all the women. She get most of my love. Now tell me, is Malia ungrateful? Yeah. For that you're here, because they're very grateful. See the attitude in her face?
Say, ooh, that was a good one. Let's make some sense back into me, baby.
That was a good one, Zoga. That was a good one. Slap a bitch back to sense. Like, stop wasting our fucking time making this shit about you, ho. This about me. Rub my motherfucking legs and my toes and suck on my toes, bitch. And Malia can't sit up and be strong for black women. We got to get rid of this weak, ho. She weak. You're a weakness. You're the weakest link. And everybody sees it now.
I said, I do.
You don't seem like you feel like you do. Bitch, you ungrateful. That's why you're about to lose your spot. When you lack gratitude, you lose what you have. And you have lacked gratitude. And that's why you're on the way out. You're ungrateful, ho. Don't nobody owe you shit. Don't nobody owe you shit, Malia. You got to work in real life. You're not that beautiful that a nigga gonna bag on you. You're not that bad. You just not. I mean, being all the way honest with you, a nigga ain't gonna bag on you the way I'm doing. A nigga ain't gonna take care of you like I'm. You gonna work at Walmart, bitch. You gonna be...
Abusive partners, cult leaders, dictators, and other sociopathic manipulators all follow the same brainwashing pattern to gain power over others. The first step is to idealize, which would include promises, charm, flattery, mirroring sympathy, pity stories, apologies, attention, generosity, gifts, adoration, and ranking you above others. To devalue would include lies, insults, belittling, criticizing, minimizing, mocking, projection, hypocrisy, gaslighting, silent treatment, threats, guilt, ambiguity, triangulation with others. And ultimately, the goal is to control you and keep you from discovering that the very foundation of who they are is a lie.
Nigga, you might get a relationship.
Well, suck your dick and lick your toes,
and
kids.
And we your average bitch that work at Walmart.
And we your average bitch that work at Walmart.
All you gotta do is get our mind right.
All you gotta do is get our mind right.
Yeah! Yo, nigga, I got you. I'm gonna put you on, nigga. I got the fish in. Yeah!
Keep going.
Come back in the channel, bitch. Stop playing with me. Next time I'm smacking you, I keep telling you, I keep my. I'm being a good motherfucker. Power down.
Yeah.
Up. You see the hoes listening to me? Bitch, you're not getting a lot of my energy. Slap her. What the fuck is wrong with you, bitch? Keep playing with God.
Abuse by proxy. Begin smear campaign. Tarnishes your image by turning people against you with an intention of destroying your social support. Raises supporters. Manipulates people to take their side and believe fabricated stories that have no ground in reality. Sends flying monkeys. Chooses some of the most obedient and compliant side takers to abuse the victim on narcissist's behalf, stalking, threatening, and harassing. Re-victimizing the victim. Victim is re-traumatized and retargeted via others. Goes through the cycle of abuse once again. However, in the physical absence, but indirect presence of the narcissist.
Here's the thing. In the country, it's something called
treason.
When you betray your family, it's punishable by death. Malia turned on our family yesterday, bro. In indigenous times, that was punishable by death. We can't do that now because there's a law and a judicial system sit on top of us. But in nature, she would never disrespect me because I'm her chief. And I am her way of living and surviving. She would never. The moment she did it, the woman would, they would kill her. That's how it is in the movies. They show you. Because that's how it is in culture. That's just the truth. We can't do that because white supremacy is here now. Because the planet, we didn't land on planet Rock. What does it say? Plymouth Rock. Plymouth Rock landed on us. So the judicial system on top of us won't let us be indigenous and in our ways. So niggas in the hood have always been fighting each other. Tribes have always been fighting each other, nigga. Ab has always been a part of us. When they got here, we was fighting each other. There was a certain laws we lived by.
Malia would haul ass.
What kind of ass like? Like she felt like that's it.
Yeah, like I was speeding off.
In those moments when I do run off and run away, I come back and I will always be here. I will always be one with.
I'll always.
All I can say is they better stop messing with Malia. A person can only take so much, and it's clear that Malia was at the end of her rope during the last month that the three guy was a free god. Y'all heard her screaming like a demon, or maybe the real her trying to come out. But as mentioned in this video, it's the quiet ones that you really need to worry about, because they'll catch you when you least expect it and unleash all of the anger they built up remaining silent. And somehow Aya, Sheba, and Neytiri avoid attacking Malia, and Malia manages to keep her hands off of them and Zoka and Efru too, despite what they do. So my point is that it can be done. And this isn't just about peer pressure from Eligio and friends or envy necessarily. You know, I compare them to bullies on the playground who get beat at home, so they unleash their pent-up anger and frustration on the other kids. And Malia is the designated scapegoat, and they feel safe, you know, slapping the taste out of her mouth because she hasn't hit back yet. You know, Zoka and Efru make Malia their punching bag to please their master. Pummeling Malia equals instant praise from Poppy. And Zoka and Efru might not care about being queen, but they gotta secure their place in the big house. And, you know, honestly, don't Zoka and Efru know that they look weak jumping people? Especially someone that's been in such poor health that they call their sister. And if they are, you know, all reflections of one another, you know, would they want people to gang up with them, gang up on them in the same fashion that they do with Malia? And then meanwhile, Malia keeps coming back for more, like a faithful old dog that doesn't know any better. Or better yet, a stray dog that has nowhere else to go. And Eligio, he instructed her to burn her bridges, as you saw, again, with the last little bit of family that she has left. And one thing's for certain, two things for sure, all of the members needed a break from Eligio Bishop by the time he was arrested. He was out of control. All of them are beaten down in some way, whether it be emotionally, physically, sexually, you know, some sort of combination of all three. But it's no excuse to abuse anyone else. And Malia gets more than her fair share of abuse, not only from Eligio, but everyone else involved. You know, whether they're hitting her, laughing at her, or just standing by, saying nothing and watching it happen. Nobody's hands are clean. And I'm scared that Malia will snap if these shenanigans do start up again and hurt herself, somebody else, or both. Because a person once more can only take so much. And if Eligio Bishop gets out, he will start this bully shit up again eventually. And the difference will be that Malia has probably been living peacefully, you know, these past few months, and or maybe longer, and she won't assume the position of whipping boy so easily, because she hasn't been conditioned lately. And no matter how you spin it, their actions, Zoka and Efru, are heartless, and they are mindless at this point. And it's sad, because they're both smart, beautiful girls that had a lot going for them before they met Three God. And all I can say is you've been warned, especially Eligio, Zoka, and Efru. So, all of you and the other members of the cult, keep playing. And see what eventually happens to you, whether it be in this life or the next. And I'm just wondering, will this break be long enough to break Eligio Bishop's evil spell on the Carbonation cult members once and for all? Definitely not true, because that's true love. But only time will tell, you know, if the others will remain in bondage. And just in case, I'll keep building my case, harvesting up the highlights of this horror show known as the Carbonation Cult. And there's so much more to come from me and my anti-cult movement. So Do like and subscribe to see the upcoming videos about the pedophiles of Carbonation, Natureboy's allegations, and Baby Jaw's exploitation, for instance. Matter of fact, by the time you see this video, they may be posted. So please check out my channel. And thanks for sharing your precious time with me. Your girl, Polly.